Hello and welcome to Recombo. I'm Tom Dehan and today we're going to be unboxing the Huawei Watch GT 3. Now you might have already spotted that this looks nothing like a traditional Huawei Watch GT wearable, for the fact that traditionally those were, well, priced and aimed at more of the fitness crowd. And because that crowd has been spoiled by fantastic fitness trackers for so many years, the GT series was also priced at a more affordable rate. And so is this, still at £229, which is a lot more affordable than the 300 plus rate of the Huawei Watch 3. Yet, this looks nothing like a GT watch now. It's gone for that premium look. And honestly, to look at it, you wouldn't think this was aimed at the fitness crowd at all. So yeah, a bit of a strange one, but I guess we're gonna have to unbox this and figure out what the deal is. And this is the Huawei Watch GT 3. Now, this stands at about the mid-range of Huawei's wearables. It's just below the traditional Huawei Watch 3. The GT range has always been more for the sort of sporty set, you know, anyone who loves having a decent fitness tracker on their wrist. Except this time, you'll notice, particularly if you've had any experience with the GT 2, this time around, it's gone under a massive design overhaul. In fact, as far as I'm concerned, this just looks like the Huawei Watch 3, except the only major difference being the fact that this costs so much less because it's part of the GT 3 range. But I say, let's just dive right in and see how much of a difference this overhaul has made. Let's take that off. Ooh, let's pop that there for a second. That is quite a nice little display. Gotta hand it to Huawei. They do know how to make these unboxings fun. Let's take this bad boy out. Pop that there for a sec. Ooh, that is quite nice. Look at that logo there. Pretty solid stainless steel link watch strap going on here. I'll be honest, it's not my favorite type. Personally, I much prefer, I've got the Tick Watch Pro 3 Ultra right here, and I like this sort of silicon rubber strap or even a leather strap. These tend to, I don't know, they just irritate my wrist quite a bit, but I know some people prefer them. So, hey, you know, you've got the option here. I know that this is just one of many options. We've just been sent this particular one for review. And yeah, honestly, so recently I tested the Huawei Watch 3 Pro, which is quite a bit chunkier than this, but if I'm being honest, very similar to look at. Honestly, these are really identical. It's just the size of these two things. This is a bit lighter, which makes sense if you want to be taking this to the gym. Don't want it to be too cumbersome. But again, for that reason, that's exactly why I would be swapping out the watch strap, because honestly, there's nothing worse when it comes to working out at the gym than this metallic strap. It's just going to cause all sorts of irritation. And in fact, I wonder if there's a spare watch strap in here. Let's have a look. Let's dive back into the box. Because there was one with the Huawei Watch 3. I wonder if I can actually get into this. Ah, so there you go. You got a couple of additional links for the strap. If that is too small, you can just get these sorted either at a professional spot, or if you're feeling extra DIY-ish, then by all means, do it at home. Let's have a look. So here is the charging strap. Let's see if I can actually get into this thing. Pop that there for a second. Yeah, I tell you, I quite like the one, or the charging dock that Huawei uses for its watches, because it's a lot more substantial than what you get for the Tick Watch or most Wear OS watches. Like recently, the Fossil Gen 6 comes with little charging dock that's about half the size of this and probably twice as flimsy, whereas this has a decent sort of, although let's say, will that fall off? Yeah, it's not quite as magnetic as you would like it to be, but it is bigger and there's just more space there, so you're more likely to actually hit it if you drop it there onto the dock. Let's see what else we've got. I see a little bit of literature there, everyone's favorite. Yeah, standard stuff. Yeah, quick start guide. For all the stuff you want to know. I mean, who doesn't know this stuff at this point? Let's see, I think that might be it for the unboxing. Just double checking, I've not missed anything. Yeah, you know what? I think that's it, which is a bit of a shame. I would have preferred it if there was an extra watch strap in here, one that was probably a bit better suited for workouts, but you know what? I guess that's what you get by going for the more affordable option here, so it's probably not going to be the worst thing, particularly if you are going for one of the more workout friendly straps. So that's the unboxing out of the way. It's time to get this connected and see what it's like using the Huawei Watch GT3. And this is the GT3 up and running in action. So first things first, the screen. I don't know how well this is coming across in the video, but I'm looking at this and it's just so bright and really nice to look at. And let's see if I can see what other watch faces are hanging around. Maybe I can find something that's really colorful to really give an idea. Let's see what's going on here. I mean, that's probably a bit too baller for my taste, if I'm being honest, but you know, it kind of does a job of showing just how nice and bright this screen can get. So if you've not used a Huawei watch before, let me be the first to show you then that this is the app gallery or the app library for the watch. It's set up very reminiscently to the Apple Watch. So if I had a few more apps, it would look a bit more impressive, but it's not that bad when you're zoomed in, kind of get a look at all the different things that are here. Huawei has a very strange proprietary music app, which, let's face it, if you don't have a Huawei phone, you can't really make the most of, because just, yeah, all that ongoing Google stuff does impact the usability of this watch. But for basic things like workouts, notifications on your wrist, and having a smartwatch that has a decent battery life, the Huawei Watch, well, all of the Huawei watches tend to knock those aspects out of the park. So simple tap up there, as you saw before, brings you to the menu and back. Now, if you swipe across the screen, it brings you to the different main facets of the watch itself. Heart rate monitoring, which would be running if I was wearing it properly, and blood oxygen level, which again, I always maintain is never the kind of thing that, it's not a necessary feature for most people, but if you're hiking all the time or you do have health issues where blood oxygen comes into play often, then it's worth having, but for most people, you're fine. So here is where the standard overview of your fitness would be had I taken this out for a run. That's what I will be doing for the final review. It's not too dissimilar to the rings format that Apple has. So if you've used an Apple Watch before, then you'll know exactly what to expect. Now, if we go over to the other side, there is a health app here. So Huawei has been putting more of an emphasis on, I guess, the holistic aspect of health. So well-being, not too dissimilar to what Fitbit has done with stress tracking and focus on meditation. Let's see. Oh no, that's as far as it goes. Yeah, I definitely need to get a couple more apps on here. It's usually a bit more going on. Now, if I hit the little button there down at the bottom, this is where you can bring up the different workout plans that you have set and a couple of different workouts. Now, for the most part, Huawei's selection of workouts is pretty good, but there are just a few things missing which I would like to see appear. So for instance, let me just double check, because I think yes. So weightlifting, something I like to incorporate in my routine, but it's just not here at all. So I always have to dive into other, which just feels like, I don't know, it's just when I look back and it'll be, you know, running, rowing, other, and I think, what was that it gives me no information. So I do wish that that was a bit different. And to be honest, that's why I do tend to revert back to the Apple Watch. But what I will say is that for the design of this thing, it's really hard to beat. This really is one of the nicest looking smartwatches you can get right now, especially for the price. But what's most impressive about this watch is, of course, the design. Honestly, it just, at £229, it is one of the nicest looking smartwatches I have ever seen. And at that price, it's beating TicWatch Pro, Apple Watch, Fitbit Sense. And to be honest, this just looks, from an aesthetic point of view, so much better than all of those. Plus, it comes with a quoted 2 weeks of battery life, which, you know, if you've used some of the most premium smartwatches out there, you'll know that some of them can just barely cut past the 3 day mark. I mean, the Apple Watch still has that same 18 hour battery life that it's been running now for God knows how long. I really wish Apple would change that. So 2 weeks really is a world away from what you get with most of those watches. And yeah, I think I'm really eager to see how this one fares, particularly against the Huawei Watch 3 and the Huawei Watch 3 Pro. And that's it for the Huawei Watch GT 3. Keep an eye out for our full review soon. And if you have any questions about, well, anything to do with this watch, then please let us know in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe to Recombo.